So I'm going to start the presentation. Very good morning, the students. We are learning the subject of antenna and the propagation. We are on the chapter number one, that is a uniform plane flow. And in the uniform flow, we are on the first topic. The topic is nothing but your query resistivity quantity theorem. And this contains in the last session, we have conducted on the basic concepts related to our basic electromagnetic. We have studied about the radiations, we have studied about quantum vectors, we have studied about the pointing as well as the vectors, pointing vectors, or the theorems which are related to the pointing vectors. Today we will go for 20 the pointing theorem. In that, we are interested to calculate to find out the amount of the power or the average power while your wave are traveling and the propagating in the space, that is the electric as well as the magnetic fields. If they that is traveling in the space, how we can calculate. What we can say is the laws we need while you are going to derive such expression that we will see today. So in the pointing theorem, how this theorem come from? So you can say the pointing theorem is one of the most important results in the electromagnetic theory. It tells us about the power flowing in an electromagnetic field. Already we are aware from the basic concept related to the pointing theorem, that is nothing but we are interested to find out the amount of the average power, that is nothing but the IV average power, okay, or the P average power, in the especially for the calculating the in the electric as well as the magnetic field. And this name pointing is came from the scientist name John Henry Pointing. Okay, so these are the basic things of how this theorem came, so how it was developed, okay, by the pointing vectors, which are the parameter we need to consider, how we have calculated the electromagnetic field, that energy stated in the conservation, or whether that electric and the magnetic field. Okay, so how the gravitational will be affect, what are the measurements of the Newton's gravitation, we should aware why we are going to continue this session, that is related to what. Study in the electromagnetic field, these lines or these expressions are already we have done, because we know that the total four major points or the parameters are very important. That is nothing but the E, D, B as well as the H. So E and okay, but if you are going with the help of the Maxwell equation, you will be able to find in the cross product, the electric field will be transferring the magnetic and the magnetic will be transferring in the electric. That you can observe with the help of this expression. That is nothing but gradient L cross E equals minus dou P by dou T. It means that we are interested to cross product in the electric field by considering the magnetic parameter or with respect to the time varying. Okay, my wave is traveling, propagating, so I am interested to find out how much amount of time required for that driving process of the wave propagating from the electric to magnetic and the magnetic to electric. Okay, so in this way, the electric and the magnetic field density, or we can calculate how they are posted, similar to that, the magnetic field in terms of time density, along with the electric field density. So these are the two expression, that is nothing but del cross E is equal to minus dou V by dou t with respect to the time period from electric to magnetic field, equal to that magnetic to electric, that is nothing but del cross H is equal to J plus of dou D by dou t. Okay. So in this way, these are the expressions. Simultaneously, how we can find by considering these two expressions, these two expression in electric and magnetic field, by considering these two expression, how we can obtain the final equation of your the power flow or the through with the help of the Poynting theorem that we will. So what we are doing exactly in both the sides, we are with the help of the dot product, we are multiplying the magnetic field, that is nothing but magnetic field intensity, that is nothing but the H on the both the sides. So to the expression number one, which is my expression number one, this is my expression number one, and del cross of E minus dou V by dou T. So I am multiplying with the H with the dot product. So here also H. Similar to the second expression, I am multiplying with the dot E. Okay, so twice J dot E. In the first, exactly the similarity or the vectors of a similar equations, we are getting at one side. In a, one way, the magnetic field will be multiplied to the electric field, and at one side, the electric field will be multiplied to the magnetic. So that is nothing but the vector identity. And finally, what we are getting, that is nothing but the E cross of H, that is the gradient of that. Again, finally, we are taking in the common way, and we are substituting what is my del cross of E and what is my del cross of H. These two expressions, again, we are substituting their values, H. Del dot E cross H. So in the last session, this expression that after getting finally, so you will assume that with the help of the Ohm's law, and you are going to apply that Ohm's law to the electric current. So that current density is equal to J is equal to conductivity into E. And the same thing, wherever we are having the J, that is the current density, we are pushing the sigma, that is conductivity into E. Okay, we are and the rest of the thing will be active. So in this way, we are trying to simplify the expression to get in the proper form. Okay. So here in next, finally again, this expression will be as it is. This E is nothing but the E square, and just we are taking in the mod to avoid the imaginary part, or we can say minus magnitude. Okay. And the remaining part will be as it is. So similarly, in the other case, that is again the E dot E cross of H minus the this one. With the help of the, what you can say, the chain rule, or you can say the calculus method. So what we are doing, we are again separating this E form as well as the H form. So how we are going to take this one? So see here, this is in the minus form. We are going to shift in the other side, so that this minus will become as a plus. So e dot dou d by dou t will be equal to, so the rest of the part we know very well, the e is equal to epsilon d. Likewise, so what is d again? The d is equal to again the e dot of so and so. So this we are going to substitute the value of the d as well as the e. D is equal to epsilon e, or e is equal to d by epsilon. Likewise, similarly, b is equal to mu h, or the h is equal to b by mu. Likewise, you can substitute wherever you are finding the b, wherever you are finding the d, you can substitute, so that we can simplify this expression. And hence, the del dot in brackets, the cross product is electric and the magnetic field. So minus conductivity into mod of e square. Again, you are going to substitute finally. How you are getting this mu and this one? Just because b is equal to mu h and d is equal to epsilon e. By substituting all the things, there will be multiplication, there will be square, and finally you are getting multiplication. So in this way, we are getting the differential form. We have again, we are substituting from the pointing theorem. We are getting del dot E cross H is equal to minus conductivity mod of E square minus dou by dou T. This is time varying. Okay, time varying field. In time varying field, we are interested with time. This is related to the magnetic field. This is related to the electric. At one side, you can continue with the surface, and at one side, you can continue with the volume. That is the, by applying the Gauss's law, or with the help of the Gauss's law, you can go for the surface, and with the help of the volume, okay, differential volume, you can go for the further equation. So see here, this part is one. This is the current density, this is the magnetic field, and this one is the electric field. Now apply here the Gauss's law to this term, that is nothing but del dot E cross of H. We are applying Gauss's integral of closed surface of d dot ds. So here the normal to the plane, that's why the value we have kept here at the place of gradient, that is n dot of ds. Whereas in the entire term, we are applying integral of volume V. Surface, that is nothing but electrostatic field. The surface is stationary at that time. How you can find the expression? That is integral of E cross H bracket dot n dot of ds. How we can get? Station is built, that is nothing but you are the pointing. How the power can be get? So there are three possibility. Already we are aware how the power can get, that is P is good energy form, dissipated power is one form, that is increasing the electric stored energy is the one form. So in this way, you can find easily the amount of the power either with the help of the magnetic field, or with the help of the dissipated power, or with the help of the electric stored energy. So likewise, you can find easily. So I square R is there, V into I is there, and V square by R is also there. So how we can interpret this one? So S is nothing but, S is nothing but a stationary form. So whatever we have got at the previous, the final, what we can say, final expression. That final current density form, including the middle form as typical, the electric network. So in this same expression, we are going to apply, no doubt at all. Okay, so what are the changes here? So this part is nothing but related to the, again, the with the help of the Gauss's law. But here, first part, which is related to the current density, that is nothing but the power dissipated as a heat, which is measured in terms of the joules. Okay, Similarly, in the middle part, which is related to the magnetic field, how we are getting the rate of change of the stored magnetic energy. This form is nothing but the stored magnetic energy, and last is nothing but the rate of change of stored electric energy. So all these things in terms of the energy we are getting, and finally we get it in the form of the power. Okay, so first is related to the dissipation of the heat, middle is the energy storing in the magnetic field, and last is the energy storing in the electric field. Likewise, we are getting. So the right hand side will be equal to power flowing into the volume of the space. So this form is nothing but right hand side is equal to left hand side, or left hand side is equal to right hand side. So right hand is exactly nothing but your the right hand side is equal to your entire term is nothing but power flowing into the volume of the space. Similarly, in the next, finally, what we are getting, hence the integral of flow surface of E cross of H is equal to NdS will be equal to power flowing into the region, the entire region, because we are taken as the consider as the volume. So how we can say that the integral of E cross of H and N dot ds will be equal to power flowing out of the region. So by the definition, that is nothing but definition of the pointing vector, and we know very well S is nothing but the pointing surface or the pointing vector, that is S is equal to E cross of H. So this E cross H is nothing but my the product of electric magnetic field. At the other side is nothing but your the surfaces, the region, or you can say the power which is flowing in the particular region. So that is nothing but integral of D or ds instead of D, we are taking here the, that is nothing but the pointing vector denoted by S, and dot of ds, which is equal to power flowing out of the region. And whenever you are taking as your the current density, that time the current flowing out of the region. Okay, if you are saying the J, and if you are talking about the S, in terms of the power we are talking, and whenever you are taking the J, that is in terms of the current we are talking about that. So J is nothing but the current density, either the vector or the current. Okay, how we cross H. So see here, with the help of this vector also we can identify, with the help of direction we can identify. Already we have done in the electromagnetic field EFT of our unit number one vectors. How the direction can be shown, how we can calculate the length, okay, how we can find the coordinate. Okay, so see here, so the E will be traveling in which particular direction, the H is traveling in the other direction. How we the east direction, where is my S? So in this way, the direction of the flow, power flow will be there. So this S is equal to E cross H. Equals to E cross H. So E is here, H is here, other direction we are as the vectors, and S is other direction. So we choose the direction, and we choose also the one X and the Y, and then this will be the Z. So in this way, S is nothing but the power, and it is measured in the vacuum square. How the surface is S, or the pointing vector, or the pointing surface, okay, compared to other these things in the direction intensity will go, and this is nothing but normal to the plane. And so in this way, the S is from the left, okay? So indirectly, you can say the power So this P can be find power integral of S as dot of n into ds. So this is again how we can find the pointing vector time average or the time varying. So as in time harmonic field, so S will be in the form of x, y, z and the t. Whenever the t is there, we can find easily that is nothing but in terms of time varying. Okay, remember, otherwise x, y and the z are the three coordinates of the particular direction, but whenever you are at the time in the plane, of electric field as well as the magnetic field. So same thing, the surface of the pointing vector or the pointing surface will be equal to electric as well as the magnetic field. See here. So in this way, the E will be in the x, y, z and with respect to time period. Similarly, x, y, z magnetic field with respect to the time period. Okay, real term is there and we are applying to e raised to the power exponential of j omega t and this one. So finally, from the our previous discussion, or you can say the previous which we have calculated, S with respect to the time period will be equal to E with respect to time period cross of H with respect to the time period. Likewise, 1 by 2 RE E cross of H. Already we have done in the EFT last time. So 1 by 2 RE into, that is the real form is there. So 1 by 2 RE in bracket E cross of S after simplifying the above expression. So in this way, by the complex pointing vector, S is equal to 1 by 2 E cross of H, okay, and when comma z comma x, y, z, if you are talking, if you're taking the real part, okay. So in this way, you can note the imaginary part of the complex pointing vector corresponds to the VARs flowing in the space, okay. So that is the voltage amperes thing which is applicable. So finally, you can say if you are going to work this. Going to use this pointing vector if you are talking about the circuit theory. So although the pointing vector can always be used to for the calculation of the power flow at a lower frequency in the circuit theory, especially that can be used, okay, in the easier form. So here we can assume that this is the transmission line. So from the one place to another place, definitely we required to find out how much amount of the power is flowing and how that can be traveled, how that can be propagate, which parameter we need to take care while you are going for the electric as well as the magnetic field, so that we can identify the rest of the thing. Because if you are talking about the power, it means directly you are talking about the current and the voltages in the system or in the transmission line or at the what you can say, the station side. Okay, so in this way you can find. So here the initial voltage or this that is applied and the plus minus here and the intersection of the transmission line where the amount of the current will flow. Now you are interested to find out the voltage also and the frequency, the power we are going to measure. So here the two kinds of the power at a lower frequency, PF and the the real power. So like this you can find easily. Finally, this is nothing but the load resistor or the impedances. So here you are finding the PF, that is nothing but the at a lower frequency, what will be the power. So integral of closed circuit of P in bracket E cross of H is nothing but the Z. And normal to the plane here, we are taking the direction of the Z. That's why the Z dot of ds is there. Or in the frequency domain, you can write the same thing, that is the PF is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, 1 by 2 R integral of same thing, E cross of H, which will be Z dot of ds. So all this, whenever you are finding the ds, you can say this is nothing but the Gaussian law. By using that Gaussian law, we can find easily. Similarly, same expression, we can go for the 1 by 2. Real term instead of taking either the complex or the real, if you are considering the product, that is nothing but the voltage and the current. So in this way we have tried to simplify or derive this expression that is related to the average power, that is nothing but the pointing vector theorem, you can say. So we have started with the pointing vector, that is nothing but the E cross of H, and then we have end with the complete theorem by assuming the Maxwell, by assuming the current density, by assuming the Gaussian, okay, by assuming the vector identity, by assuming the chain rule, each and everything we have applied here to get this final expression, which is related to the average power. So this average power is in terms of the heat, in terms of the magnetic field, in terms of the electric field, along with your, you can say the real time varying field. We have taken, we have assumed this average power, okay. So this was related to your what we can say the pointing theorem of the last content or the topic related to your the uniform plane wave. So in this uniform plane wave, we have studied all the parameters which are related to your the basic fundamental related to electric field, basic fundamental related to the refraction, reflection, diffraction, you can say the radiation, the power radiation. So the vectors, the average power, what you can say, the antenna related, how we can design and which parameters are affected. All these things we have studied in the unit number one. So this was the last topic, that was nothing but you are the pointing theorem today we have learned. So in this way, I'm going to conclude the unit number one, that is nothing but the uniform plane wave.